time with Dad. This is my favorite story time. Under the bed in my secret fort, and I'm gonna read.
Hi everyone, welcome to the show. We got an amazing story for you. Are you ready?
Oh, it's so fantastic. How?
We're reading the Secret Cat Diaries. Shh, it's a secret. This one's about help. Sammy wanted.
What kind of cats are Sammy?
Yeah, this is a story of a rogue group of misfits and outcasts. There is a spell that locks all the citizens in their home for over 1 year. Even the samurai cats of Sacred Scroll and Monastery are put to sleep for 1 year.
Oh, how did that happen? Can you tell us the secret cat diary?
Yeah, of how Sammy Ray wanted. But once upon a time, Brutus was a skinless and hairless, mean, fierce Sphinx cat who was a dropout from Dueling Swords Academy. And he didn't pass to be a samurai, no. So he was very angry. And then he was walking home all upset that he didn't pass to become a samurai. This is awful. Let me become a samurai. What am I going to do? Oh, I have no fur to stretch. Oh, being a hairless cat is awful. And I'm mad. Oh, I stubbed my toe. Ouch, ouch, ouch. What is this thing sticking up out of that ground? Oh, you stupid thing. And he finds a old plastic bottle and tosses it. And then green smoke is released from the bottle. And a beautiful genie and a beautiful costume pops up.
Hello.
Hi. I am Selena and I am your genie and you have 3 wishes.
What? What's that you say? 3 wishes?
Oh, well, can you make those samurais fall asleep at Sacred Scroll Monastery so that I can become the new ruler of this Whisk of Falls?
Oh, sure.
But don't you want to be a big fish in the city and be a king?
A king? Yeah, I have wishes. I wish to be a king of Whisk of Falls.
That's perfect. You'll be the king. But if anyone challenges your rule before 1 year's time, they have a right to fight, to challenge you and win their kingdom back.
Okay, okay. Oh, and Jenny, can you make me handsome?
Don't push your luck, Brutus.
Don't you have plastic surgery wishes yet?
I'll try, said Selena. So she blinked and blinked and focused on Brutus' face and the zap, 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 bing, bing, bing. Voila.
Oh, I don't know about this.
Brutus looked and looked in the mirror and he was a monkey.
Well, this is certainly interesting.
Cut with the public relations, Selena. The truth.
Oh, let me try again.
The genie blinked again and went, think, think, think. And Brutus' face looked like a big, hairy warthog with long, pointy bangs.
How do I look? I'm kind of thirsty, and I want to howl. And I want to bite something.
Yikes, said Jeannie, and she blinked again quickly. Blink, 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 and changed Brutus' face. And now he looked like a bat. And he was upside down, and he was shrieking high-level sonic sounds that hurt the genie's ears.
Ow! Ow! Ouch! Ouch! Ouch!
So she blinked again, and Brutus' face turned exactly back the way it was before.
How do I look?
I feel so much better. Let me look. Brutus was headed in mirror.
There you go, said Selena,
and cringed in fear that Brutus would like his regular face.
I love it, said Brutus. Oh, look at me. I am so handsome. Great job.
Now, did you forget something? Jeannie got very worried.
What, Master?
Brutus pointed to the top of his head and stared in the mirror.
My crown!
That's as in King's crown.
Oh, yes, Brutus, sure. Zap, zap, zap. Brutus had a beautiful crown of gold with a ruby, a sapphire, and a diamond on each of the pointed stars. And he even had a royal red and white robe with fur and a sapphire sword to hold in his hand. "I feel so regal," said some Brutus. "Meow, meow. Okay, let's hop and go to Dagger's castle. I want everyone to know I'm now their new king. This is awesome. I love having a genie." "I'm glad you're pleased, Brutus." "Attention, ladies and cattlemen, all cat citizens and all fur citizens of Whiskapaws. I, Brutus, am now your new king and ruler. I will rule this kingdom." "Hey, we don't have any rulers," the citizens cried out. "We've never been ruled in over 1,000 years. The crowd was angry. "Purr, purr, purr. Meow, meow, meow. Woof, woof. Meow. Genie, can you help get me out of this plastic bottle?" "Yes, now, look at all these citizens in their homes. They accept me as their new king." The citizens cried out, "We have samurai and they'll help us." "Yes, yes," shouted the citizens. "We will get our samurai to attack you and return us back to having no ruler." But no samurai came. The citizens looked alarmed. "Oh no, where are our samurai?" cried a little boy. A mom started to cry. A dad started to cry. No samurais came to the rescue. Citizens shouted for samurai. "Samurai, samurai." But no samurai came. Brutus smiled. "No one's going to help you because your samurai are sleeping. I am a genie and I'm ruling this kingdom, so you better get used to it." The citizens soon learned that Brutus wished their samurai asleep, and they were hopeless to obey Brutus as the new king or be forced to stay at home for a whole year. "Any citizens refusing to worship me, recognize me as your new king, will have to stay home for a year." Suddenly, everyone in Whiskapaw retired to their home, except for a couple of citizens. "Where did everyone go, genie?" "I think they went to their house because they do not want a ruler." "Oh, well, what about these cats?" "I think they're hungry." "Oh, great. Hey, I have a couple of snacks. Look at this fresh mouse and this delicious mozzarella cheese." A cat named Chaglin and a dog named Meatball and a raccoon named Dumplings decided to stay with Brutus. And a big Maine Coon cat named Scruffy McGraw and a smaller Maine Coon cat named Scruffles McGraw went up and wanted some cheese and some fresh live mouse. That mouse looks good. And a Ravenclaw came up. "I love cheese." "Well, great. You guys can be my evil cat defenders, and you will protect me."
"Meow, meow, meow. I love fresh mouse and cheese."
So, nothing like a cheap trick for to give someone a dog's nap or a cat's nap. So, King Brutus had 3 citizens he ruled with, and the other citizens went home and tried to come up with a plan to get their kingdom back. It was almost a year, and the citizens were all stuck at home. "This is awful. We're stuck at home," said a stray cat and a tabby cat and a British short hair. "This is awful. We're staying at home, and we're ordering pizzas, and almost every house has their own gym set up with a stationary bicycle, a trampoline, stretchy bands, and blow-up lap pools, and a walking machine." "But I'm so bored in my house," said a British tabby cat. "I am too. We're all bored in our house, even though we have been having so much fun watching all the films. I'm so cut off, and I've been watched on every single film and TV show ever," said a Japanese bobtail. "Oh," said the tabby cat. "Oh, I have been working out on my stationary bicycle, and I've been jumping trampolines. I've been eating pizzas, and I'm getting fat," said a tabby cat. So everyone wanted to go outside and play in the park and refused to let Brutus be their king.
Then one day, they decided. I have an idea, said the British short hair. Let's put an ad in the paper. What kind of ad? Well, I've got it. Samurai wanted. Someone will answer the ad and someone will rescue us. I know there's someone out there and we will give them a reward. How much money do we have? I've got a couple of rubles. Let's put all our rubles together and have a reward. 100,000 rubles. So, then, Sammy, a stray Siamese cat, was walking through the town and opened the paper. As he sat at the silver mew to have a delicious tea and crumpet. Now have a paper, said Sammy the cat. And suddenly, there's a paper. Sammy Ray wanted. Wow, they want someone to defend their kingdom and break the spell over the sleeping samurai. The samurai are asleep in this town? I have nothing to lose and everything to gain. I've been dreaming about being a samurai my whole life. I've always dreamed of being a samurai, and now it's my chance. It says no experience. No experience is necessary. Exceptional sword skills and just a good mind. Maybe I can bluff my way with this exceptional sword skill, said Sammy. I've never used a sword before. And it says no experience, so that's perfect. Just a good mind. I mind my own self, so I'm a fit. Let me see, it says here. I just have to defeat Brutus, a vicious, ruthless, evil king with a powerful genie, and break the spell that put the samurai to sleep. Wow, no one can do that. Suddenly, a pig walked up. Hey, what's that you're reading? Help wanted samurai. I've always wanted to be a samurai. Hi-ya, hi-ya. Well, you're a pig. That's right, I'm Iggy the Piggy. A beautiful, furry, fluffy Siberian Persian cat walked up. Her name was Talia. Hi, I'm Talia. What's that you're reading? Samurai Wanted. That's me. I can be samurai. You can, said Sammy. Well, sure I can. I want a ruble necklace. It's not a diamond necklace, said Iggy the Piggy. It isn't? What's a ruble anyway, said Talia. It's money. Oh boy. I've always wanted a fast racing car like a Porsche to cruise around the country and go see Venice, Italy. What do you want, Iggy? I need more room than my tiny studio apartment. My wife is about to have some babies. And I need some oink, some more room, you know? Sammy, what do you want? I want to be a samurai. What about the money? I'd like to share it with an animal sanctuary and a rescue animal group. Wow, that's so noble of you, Sammy, said Talia.
Yeah, it's certainly noble of you, said Iggy the Piggy.
Well, I'm a stray feral cat, so no use for a home. I've never had one. You're a feral cat? I've heard of feral cats. That means you cruise from land to land. That's me. Well, may the best cat or pig win. What about me? I'm a skunk, said Hada.
What about me, said Koala, a koala there, Bob.
What about me, said a cattle dog running around in circles. Well, you know, the more the merrier, but I think a koala sleeps all day long. Well, I'd like to try. So Sammy said, I feel like scratching. I'm going to go walk around and get some exercise. I need to find a nice scratching board. And his claws started scratching on the ground, and his nails felt something underneath the ground. I can't get my nail out, said Sammy. It felt like an old wooden chest with a rusty lock. And Sammy quickly opened up and found an old VHS and some cassette tapes. What is this? Said Sammy. Sammy brought the old wooden chest home to his howling, whispering inn where he was staying. What's this? The tapes say Samurai Warrior by Half Moon Penny.
So Sammy started practicing the samurai lessons daily. And one day the cassette tapes all melted up and tangled up into a big ball. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Dear me. Oh, gosh. Let me see if I can get some of these things back. So Talia popped up and said, hey, what are you doing? Oh, I'm just trying to put these tapes back together. They got all melted up and all unwired. Oh, well, let's see if I can get this in the cassette tape, said Talia. Knock, knock, knock. Hey, how do you guys know where I've been staying? Well, everyone knows. There's no one in the town. Everyone's asleep. You're the only one new in town, said Iggy the Piggy. Well, oh, Sammy was exercising to some tapes he found in an old wooden box, said Celine. Said Talia. Oh, you found some samurai tapes? Yeah, from Half Moon Wong. Half Moon Wong, I've heard of him. Well, turn it on. Now up higher and higher. That's right. Kick up with your left leg. Now switch legs. Very good. Now punch with the right hand. 3 jabs. Now punch with the left hand. 3 jabs. Boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now take your sword. We don't have swords. Just pretend. And hold it like this. And start up in the air and then down and around. Very, very good. Oh, wow. Said Half Moon Bong, with an introduction by Half Moon Penny. I've heard of Half Moon Penny. Really cool. So, oh. And you must use your inner energy and be very comfortable. Relax and concentrate on your sword. Concentrate on your sword. See your enemy ahead of you and use the light from your sword, your green light bursting out from your sword, and chant this out. Om, om, om. Meow, meow, meow. Oh, and if you need more lessons, please PayPal me at anonymous content or buy me coffee sneakies if you'd like to know anything further. This was just a sample, free tape. If you'd like, or the good stuff, you must PayPal me at anonymous content or buy me coffee sneakies. And then the tape all raveled up.
Oh, no. The tape all raveled up. Wow.
Well, I think we've learned enough. So Sammy and Theodore and Iggy started practicing with what they learned. I think he said right jab first and left jab first. Well, we've got to do it. Oh, yeah. Well, we have to fight off Brutus. And what about that? The cat warriors from the genie girl zapped up. Did you see those cats? Oh my gosh, that big Maine Coon cat Scruffy is so big. And what about the little one? Yeah. Okay, so can you remember some stuff? Okay, now follow me, said Sammy. Like stir, stir, stir. Looks like we're stirring a pot. Yep, stir the air. Nice, like this, Satali. Great, Satali. Now use some free and concentrate in your mind. Very cool. So Sammy and his crew practiced all day and all night. Meanwhile, Brutus and his samurai were eating a delicious meal of fish at the Silver Mew tea shop and having delicious tea. Okay, so how can we defeat them? said Sammy. It says a spell placed by a bad soul on a good soul can only last 1 year. Oh, when does a spell stop? Oh, in 3 days. We have 3 days to defend the kingdom and get our fur utopia back, said Talia and Iggy. Okay, so day one is starting tomorrow. We will have to win and defeat Brutus and his team. So on day one, the challenge started. And Sammy, Talia, and Iggy, Bob the Koala, who was sleeping, Rusty the cattle dog, who was just running around the circle, didn't really seem to count, but they had their ragtag misfit team of rogue samurais. Who dares to challenge my rule, said Brutus. I do, said Sammy the samurai. And I do, said Talia and Iggy the piggy.
Me too, said Bob, sleeping in a tree.
said Rusty the cattle dog, running around the circles. Okay, well, you can eat my
my gang of samurai. Meet my samurai, said Brutus. Okay, Zeenie, do yourself, zap my team. Scruffy McGraw, a menacing, big, Maine Coon cat. Gray and white, stepped up, and as he walked, the ground shook like thunder. Boom, 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 boom.
Oh, gosh, that's a big cat, said Iggy the Piggy, shaking.
That's a big cat, said Talia.
It is big, said Sammy. Oh, gosh.
Then Ravenclaw, an Egyptian spotted leopard cat, stepped up with a shaved head with a tic-tac-toe tattoo on it.
I'm Ravenclaw. Roar, roar, meow. Meow, and I have sharp claws. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, look at that guy's shaved head. Oh, that's a cool tattoo, said Iggy the Piggy. Oh, he's gonna rip your face off, said Talia. Oh, he's gonna claw you to death. And then Scruffy, Scruffles McGraw, a junior Maine Coon cat, stepped up, purring. Purr, 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 purr. And the ground shook. Boom, boom, boom. All right, said Brutus. The hairless cat. Now let the games begin. And the marker went off. Bop! The first day, the cats and samurai team fought with their swords. Clang, 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 clang. Bang, 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 bang. Clang, 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 clang. Bang, 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 bang. Click, 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 click. Sammy and his team held off Scruffy, Ravenclaw, and Scruffles. But, and they were able to hold off the thing. So it was a tie. Day two, Sammy and Talia and Ziggy and Bob, the sleeping koala, and Rusty, the cattle dog running around in circles, were tired and tired. But day two, wow, Scruffy McGraw and Scruffles McGraw and Ravenclaw don't even look like they're tired. They look well-rested and well-fed and well-slept. The score is 1-2 us, so... If you tie today, then we'll have a game day three. If not, we will win today, said Brutus, and I'm sure we're going to win today. So, Sammy, Natalia, and Iggy the Piggy put on their swords, and their green lights popped out. Ooh, said the audience. Meow, meow, green lights go, green samurai lights go. And then Brutus and Scruffy and Scruffles and Ravenclaw lit up their swords and dark, dark blue, almost black light. Ooh, boo, purr, purr, boo, boo. And Scruffy McGraw, the big Maine Coon cat, clicked and clicked, click, 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 bang, 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 clang, 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 bang, 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 bang. And they fought and fought and fought. At the end of the day, it was tied.
It is a tie contest. So day three will be the deciding factor if Brutus will be the ruler. And we're pretty sure Brutus will be the ruler because we have a sneaky plan for day three. Well, I mean, we'll see you tomorrow, everyone, citizens. So the next day, Brutus said, hey, listen, Selena, can't you do something? These cats are actually defending them. I can't. You used up all your wishes already. I did, said Brutus. Yes, the jacuzzi, the sauna, and steam room, fresh fish delivery by Daily Gourmet, Mouse Moose dessert, Scratch Masseuse Daily, gourmet catnip, gold-plated cat food and water bowls, 3,000-count Egyptian cotton sheets, cat hairball removing service, 100-foot yacht, a private jet. Okay. But the jacuzzi was so needed after chasing mice all day, said Brutus. Meow. Well, what about, we have to win the last game. Find me a way, said Brutus to Scruffy McGraw and his team and to the genie. Okay, I can use fire swords. Fire swords, then do it, said Brutus. We need to win. The next day, Brutus was on the speaker in front of Dagger Castle. Okay, this is the last day of the samurai games. And he shot the firecracker in the air. Pop, 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 let the games begin. The samurai lift up their light swords. Sammy's team's light swords turned green. And Scruffy, Ravenclaw, and Scruffles had dark black light swords. And Sammy and Scruffy started clanging and banging their swords. Clang, 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 bang, 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 bang. Clang, 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 bang, bang. And suddenly, Scruffles' dark blue light sword turned into a blazing fire. Swoosh, 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 swoosh. Oh, Sammy was shocked to see the fire, but remained calm. Remembered
half-moon thongs had remained calm. And then Sammy remembered he brought along a squeeze water bottle because it was so hot, and he squirted the water on the fire sword, and Scruffle McGraw's fire sword fizzled out. The crowd cheered, "Yeah, yeah, meow, 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 purr, purr." "What?" said Scruffles. "My sword is out." Sammy bit Scruffles, and he started to giggle. "Oh, oh, oh, ah, that's so funny. Stop, stop. Oh, my gosh, that's my tickle spot. No, no, not the tummy, not the tummy. Oh, my God." "Meow, meow, meow, meow." "Yeah, stop, stop, please." And Scruffy and Ravenclaw said, "Not so fast," as their dark blue light swords turned into fire swords light. "Oh, I have my water bottle, too," said Iggy, and splashed Scruffles' sword, and his sword went out. "I still have mine," said Ravenclaw. "Meow." Tilly said, "Well, I found a hose, and Sammy, can you turn on the water hose?" And the water blasted Ravenclaw's fire hose, and he was dripping wet. The crowd cheered, "Meow, meow, purr, purr." The clock struck 3 o'clock. "Hooray, the spell has lifted," shouted the citizens. "Sammy, you did it, Sammy. Sammy, the samurai, you did it, Sammy. Hurry up, hip, hip, hip. Hip, hip, hooray, hip, hip, hooray, Sammy did it." And the sleeping samurai woke up from Sacred Scrolls Monastery. "Sammy, you did it!" Calidor, a samurai, thanked his family for placing an ad and thanked Sammy, the samurai, Siamese cat, for answering the ad. And Calidor, the samurai, said, "I decree the winner of the 100,000 rubles to Sammy and his team." "Yay! Sammy used his sword-wielding skills, diplomacy, leadership, and, I must say, some originality. That water was excellent. Here's your check for 100,000 rubles and the key to Whisker Falls." "Woo-hoo! Yay, yay," said the citizens. "Congratulations for a well-earned job at defeating Brutus and his naughty cats." The genie applauded, and now Sammy. "Oh, Sammy, now you can have 3 wishes. "I can," said Sammy the cat. "Sure. I'm released from Brutus's spell. Oh, well, I wish to be on a tropical vacation in the Caribbean, lying in one of those hammocks on the beach, eating fresh fish and having some catnip. Oh, and to be there with my friends, Talia and Iggy the Piggy, and Bob the sleeping koala, and Rusty the cattle dog running in circles." "Yeah, woof, woof, meow, meow." And all the citizens cheered, and they had their kingdom back with no ruler, no king, and all the samurai woke up, and all the citizens lived happily ever after. The end.
I love that story. Me too. Oh, that's the best story ever. Sammy the Samurai is so amazing. Yeah. And if you can donate to the channel, buy me coffee, Sneakies, or PayPal me anonymous content. Or if you can simply subscribe and hit the 5 stars with a review. 5-star reviews. Thank you so much. Thank you. The end.